Hello and welcome to the image module of the Information Integrity Training Program. Before I tell you how the program is organized, let's start with a few reflections on the topic of image integrity itself. Images are all around us. We document our lives and habits with smartphones and portable digital devices like never before in the history of mankind. Be it in the news, in social media, or for private communication purposes, the amount of images created and exchanged every day, every minute, every second can hardly be overlooked. The total number of images captured per year can only be estimated, but it amounts into the trillions. Just try to imagine. That is a long row of zeros. Until about 30 years ago, taking a picture involved many steps and skills before a copy could be developed from a negative, a process we refer to today as analog photography. In the meanwhile, digital photography and software have radically simplified both the production and post-processing of images. But how trustworthy are images? How can we be sure visual information is reliable and not faked or altered? Software like Photoshop or GIMP can be used to create visual worlds that allow a whole new level of quality to be achieved. A person's facial expression may be altered within a heartbeat using the Photoshop Liquify tool, and almost without prior knowledge or expertise achieve most stunning results. While image processing software has become more powerful than ever, the authenticity and trustworthiness of images is gradually undermined. People simply cannot be certain anymore whether the information in the images is altered, whether a scene reflects reality or mere fantasy. This becomes a problem especially where the integrity of images has far-reaching consequences, for example in the news or politics or in the academic context. Since the beginning of the millennium, there have been numerous instances where image manipulation resulted in corrections or even in retractions of scholarly works. There have been prominent cases that were broadcasted on public media worldwide, resulting in the feeling that academic integrity in general was undermined. With every article that has to be withdrawn, the integrity of the scholarly ecosystem is harmed. One rotten apple does not necessarily spoil the whole barrel, as the proverb has it, but since science builds on science, the longer it remains undetected, the greater the damage that must be expected. In 2018, Elizabeth Bick, Arturo Casadevall and Ferik Fang estimated that up to 35,000 articles in the field of biomedicine alone must be withdrawn due to duplicated images. The real number of problematic images might be significantly higher, but of course, even a single case is one too many, since they may cause real-world consequences. Unreliable research can lead to wrong conclusions, the application of ineffective therapies, or the prescription of harmful drugs. Not all sorts of image manipulation imply fraudulent intentions. Sometimes researchers are not aware of the standards and guidelines that have been established, and often it is sloppiness or even honest error that cause inappropriate manipulation. The question now is, what can be done to fight inappropriate image manipulation? Some expect there must be some technical solution to solve the problem and to support integrity checks to detect inappropriate manipulations before publication. Others recommend to invest in better education or in putting more effort in developing all-inclusive guidelines for image preparation. However challenging the problem of inappropriate image manipulation might be, detecting such issues in scholarly works is mostly still a manual task, and there's much to be learned about images, about their properties and metadata that can be used for image integrity analysis. The HeadCenter's online certificate program on image integrity supports you in developing a more thorough understanding of how to make sure you produce, process, and manage your images according to the rules. You will learn about what sort of manipulation can cause problems, where the boundaries for image manipulation are, and what manipulations must be considered inappropriate. We address the topic of image forensics and learn how to analyze the information in an image. Scientific results must be reliable, and images play an increasingly important role as scientific data, but also in scientific communication.
This training program is addressed to all those who are professionally interested in images and image processing, to doctoral students and researchers who publish images, to reviewers or editors who check images for integrity, as well as to all those who are concerned about scientific integrity. Students learn from this program how to correctly produce, process, and reference images, how to avoid errors when using images for various purposes and in different academic fields.
If you aim to develop a more thorough understanding of image manipulation in the scholarly realm, stay tuned and watch our next video coming up in this series, which is called Image Manipulation: How Serious is the Problem? Numbers, Statistics, Estimates. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope to see you soon.